Good morning to everyone.
Dobro jutro svima.
It is a privilege to be with you again.
Privilegija je biti sa vama ponovo.
I am glad that we have air conditioning in this building.
I drago mi je da klima radi.
Last week, I had the privilege of talking to you about breathing.
Prošle nedelje sam imao priliku da pričam sa vama o disanju.
Just to give you a quick recap of the point of what we were talking about last week.
I evo samo da ukratko ponovim o čemu smo pričali prošle nedelje.
We were reading through the first part of the book of Acts on the subject of the Holy Spirit.
Pričali smo o prvom delu knjige Dela apostolskih na temu Svetog Duha.
And the main idea was that the Holy Spirit is the breath of God.
Ideja je bila da je Sveti Duh dah Gospodnji.
So to be filled with the Holy Spirit means to breathe as God breathes.
Što znači, ako ste ispunjeni Svetim Duhom, trebalo bi da dišete kao što Bog diše.
And for the early disciples, that meant realizing that God's breath is within everybody.
A za rane učenike to je značilo da je Gospodnji Duh sa svima prisutnim.
Today what I want to do is talk about some problems with breathing.
Međutim, danas bih hteo da pričamo malo o problemima u vezi sa disanjem.
Because although breathing seems like a simple task, it is something that can go wrong frequently.
Iako je disanje deluje kao veoma jednostavna stvar koju mi činimo, ipak mogu da se stvore problemi sa disanjem.
Recently, there has been no small debate about the subject of breathing.
I nedavno se razvila jedna ne baš mala debata na temu disanja.
Some people refuse to wear masks because they believe it harms their breathing.
Neki ljudi odbijaju da nose maske zato što veruju da šteti njihovom disanju.
And although the subject of masks has been the focus of the debate about breathing,
iako je tema maski bila predmet te debate o disanju,
I find it interesting that actually the biggest threat to breathing is not a mask.
Ja smatram interesantnim da je u stvari najveći predmet ove debate nisu u stvari maske.
Many of us breathe poorly, not because we're wearing a mask, but because of how we actually breathe.
Mnogi od nas imaju problema sa disanjem ne zbog maske, već upravo zbog načina na koji dišu.
I did not realize that breathing was such a difficult thing until I started working out.
Ja nisam shvatio da je disanje jedna tako kompleksna stvar dok nisam počeo da vežbam.
I discovered that breathing is actually a art form.
Shvatio sam it's actually
an art form.
Shvatio sam da je u stvari disanje jedna vrsta umetničke forme.
Specifically in the sport of weightlifting.
Naročito kada je u pitanju dizanje tegova.
When and how you breathe can make a big difference in how much weight you lift.
Kada i kako dišete čini jako veliku razliku kada je u pitanju podizanje tegova i kako to činite.
For example, if you are doing a squat,
na primjer ako radite čučnjeve,
and the bar is on your back behind your neck,
a tegovi su na vašim ramenima,
you want to make sure that before you go down into the lift, you fill your lungs with breath.
Morate, pre nego što sa tegovima na svojim leđima krenete u čučanj, vi morate da napunite svoje pluća vazduhom.
Because that will make your entire core strong.
Jer će to vaše celo telo učiniti mnogo snažnijim.
And so you need to breathe out when you come up and breathe in as you go down.
I tako, vi treba da udišete kada se spuštate i da izdišete kada se podižete.
But it's very different with other lifts.
Ali je teško i sa drugim vrstama tegova.
One of the things that I discovered when I started doing pull-ups is that breathing is very important with those lifts as well.
Disanje je također izuzetno bitno kada podižete tegove.
If you attempt to breathe when you're hanging from a bar, you'll discover that your lungs can't fill with air very well.
Ako pokušate da dišete tek pošto ste već podigli svoje tegove, shvatit ćete da vaša pluća veoma teško mogu se napune vazduhom.
And so you have to breathe in as you pull yourself over the bar.
I zato morate da dišete dok sebe podižete iznad drške za tegove.
And then breathe out as you come down.
I onda da izdišete kada se spuštate.
And this sounds like very simple stuff.
I sve ovo zvuči veoma jednostavno.
But it becomes incredibly complicated.
Ali postaje izuzetno komplikovano.
And people who are able to master the art of breathing will be much more successful in athletic activities.
I ljudi koji uspeju da razviju veoma dobru tehniku disanja biće veoma uspešni u svojim atletskim naporima.
And one of the things that I discovered when I was working out is that sometimes I can forget to breathe.
Nešto što sam otkrio jeste da ponekad ja you forget to breathe. Okay, da zaboravlja da diše.
You can be lifting a certain weight and be so focused on it that you actually hold your breath.
Toliko ste fokusirani na podizanje tih tegova da vi u stvari zateknete sebe kako zadržavate dah, ne dišete.
And of course, this harms your performance.
I naravno ovo na negativan način utiče na vaše performanse.
And so today I want to talk about one of the ways that we stop breathing spiritually.
I zato bih danas hteo da pričamo o jednom od načina u duhovnom kontekstu kako smo mi prestali da dišemo.
And there are actually three ways that we do this that are discussed in the book of Acts.
I u delima apostolskim ovo duhovno disanje postoji na tri načina.
But for the sake of time, I only want to talk about one of them.
Ali zbog vremena danas ćemo pričati samo o jednom.
But before we talk about this simple way that we quickly stop breathing the Holy Spirit, I want to look at a positive example of breathing.
Ali pre nego što počnemo da pričamo o ovom problemu prestanka duhovnog disanja, hteo bih da pogledamo prvo jedan pozitivan primerak.
I want to tell you about a character who was perhaps the best breather spiritually in the entire book of Acts.
Hteo bih da vam ispričam nešto o jednom od likova iz dela apostolske koji je verovatno najbolji primer duhovnog disanja.
We find his story beginning in Acts chapter 6.
Njegovu priču pronalazimo u delima šestom poglavlju.
Beginning in verse 1.
U prvom stihu.
It says, at that time, as the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists, or Greeks, complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution.
A u ove dane, kad se umnožiše učenici, podigoše Grci viku na Jevreje, što se njihove udovice zaboravljaju kad se deli hrana svaki dan.
So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, it is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table.
Onda dvanaestorica dozvaše i mnoštvo učenika rekoše, nije prilično nama da ostavimo reč Božju pa da služimo oko trpeze.
Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men filled with the Spirit and wisdom whom we shall appoint to this task.
Nađite, dakle, braćo, među sobom 7 poštenih ljudi punih Duha Svetoga i premudrosti, koje ćemo postaviti nad ovim poslom.
Whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word.
A mi ćemo u molitvi i u službi reči ostati.
This is a very interesting passage because it reveals a problem that emerged in the early community.
Ovo je veoma interesantan deo dela apostolskih zato što govori o problemu koji se stvorio u prvoj zajednici.
Because of the Holy Spirit, they were sharing everything that they had with each other.
Zbog Duha Svetoga, oni su delili sve što su imali međusobno.
They were trying to hold everything in common.
Sve su hteli da drže, da bude zajedničko.
But they discovered that certain people were being discriminated against in this process.
Ali su saznali da je u ovom procesu da je izvesna grupa ljudi bila diskriminisana.
The Hebrews were getting more than the Greeks.
Jevreji su dobijali više hrane nego Grci.
And so the apostles get together to solve the problem.
I tako se apostoli okupljaju zajedno da reše ovaj problem.
And at first the response of the apostles sounds like something quite negative.
I na prvu loptu reakcija apostola zvuči kao nešto veoma negativno.
It sounds like they were haughty and thought they had special privileges.
Izgledalo je kao da su oni posebni, da imaju posebne privilegije odnosu na ostale.
It almost seems as if they're saying, waiting on tables is beneath us.
Izgledalo je kao da oni kažu da poslužujemo druge ljude, to nije na našem nivou, to drugi treba da rade.
We are filled with the Spirit and we are above tasks like that.
Mi smo ispunjeni duhom i mi smo iznad tih zaduženja.
We will pray and preach, and that should be our only job.
Mi ćemo se moliti, propovedati, i to treba da bude naš jedini posao.
And of course, this is a tendency that human beings have. This is a tendency that we all human beings have.
Ovo je tendencija, navika, hvala, koju svi mi imamo kao ljudska bića.
Once we attain a certain position, we don't want to do things that are beneath us.
Kada dođemo na određeni nivo, na određenu poziciju, ne želimo da radimo stvari koje su ispod nas.
But it turns out that that's not the point of this passage.
Međutim, to uopšte nije poenta ovog dela.
The author Luke is attempting to make a different point altogether.
Luka, autor ovog dela, želi da postigne sasvim drugačiju poentu.
In the rest of the chapter and in the next, he tells a totally different story.
U ostatku ovog poglavlja i u narednom poglavlju on priča sasvim drugu priču.
The apostles and the community choose people to start waiting on tables.
Apostoli i zajednica su odabrali ljude koji će početi da služe za svim stolovima.
And so it says in verse 5, they choose a man named Stephen.
I tako kaže u petom stihu da su izabrali čoveka po imenu Stefana.
And it says he was a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit.
On je bio čovek ispunjen verom i Duhom Svetim.
He was one of the waiters who would take care of the food distribution.
On je bio, tako reći, jedan od konobara koji će se brinuti za distribuciju hrane.
He was going to do the low task.
On je taj koji će raditi te niske, nisko plaćene ili nisko pozicionirane poslove.
But watch something fascinating that happens in verse 8.
Ali pazite, nešto fascinantno se desilo u osmom stihu.
It says, now Stephen, filled with grace and power, was working great wonders and signs among the people.
A Stefan, pun vere i sile, činjaše znaki i čudesa velika među ljudima.
Remember, this is a table waiter.
Zapamtite, ovo je konobar.
And then it says in verse 10 that he was so filled with the Spirit that he began to debate with people who disagreed with him.
I u desetom stihu kaže da je on bio tako, toliko ispunjen duhom da je počeo da se raspravlja sa ljudima koji se nisu slagali sa njim.
And it says, but they could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he spoke.
I stih kaže, i ne mogahu protivustati premudrosti i duhu kojim govoreše.
And his controversial ideas become so powerful and so persuasive.
I tako su njegove kontroverzne ideje postale moćne i ubedljive.
That eventually the religious leaders grab him and bring him into the court.
Do te mere da su religijske vođe uhapsile Stefana i odvele ga na sud.
And the entirety of chapter 7 is him giving a sermon to this court.
I tako se celo sedmo poglavlje bavi njegovom propovedi koju je on imao pred sudom.
It is such a powerful and moving sermon that they stone him because of it.
Služba je bila toliko moćna i toliko ih je dotakla da su ga oni kamenovali.
This sermon is perhaps the most important sermon in the entire book of Acts.
A ova propoved je možda verovatno najvažnija propoved u delima apostolskim.
And although Stephen's death is tragic,
iako je Stefanova smrt tragična,
it ends up creating the impetus for the community to spread.
Stvorila je novi puls za celu zajednicu, novu vest koja će se proširiti.
So what is Luke's point?
I šta je Lukina poenta u stvari?
Table waiting is as good as being an apostle.
Konobarisanje je podjednako dobro kao i kada ste apostol.
When we think about the early church, we think of those 12 apostles.
Kada mislimo o ranoj crkvi, mi u stvari mislimo o tih 12 apostola.
We think they were filled with the Spirit and they were important and wise and brilliant.
Mislimo o tome kako su bili ispunjeni duhom, kako su bili važni, mudri i posebni.
But from the biblical perspective, Stephen, who is a humble, meal-prepping, carrot-chopping waiter, is just as important.
Ali iz biblijske perspektive, Stefan, čiji je zadatak bio da priprema jela, da setka voće i povrće, bio je podjednako važan kao i apostoli.
It should be all of our goal to become table waiters.
I zato bi naš cilj trebalo da bude da postanemo konobari.
We tend to listen to church leaders, important people, officials, pastors.
Mi želimo da slušamo važne crkvene ljude, pastore, vođe.
But we all ought to value table waiters much more.
Ali bi trebalo da one ljude koji se bave konobarisanjem cenimo mnogo više.
There are many examples of lowly people who have done great things by breathing the Holy Spirit.
Postoje mnogi primjeri ljudi koji su dišući dah Svetog Duha, a bili su na niskim pozicijama, činili velike stvari.
People who chose to serve simply because they knew they could make a contribution that way.
Ljudi koji su izabrali da služe iz razloga zato što su znali da na taj način mogu da doprinesu.
I think of people like the soldier Desmond Doss.
Poput vojnika Desmonda Dossa.
He was an Adventist in World War II serving in the Pacific.
On je bio adventista koji je za vreme Drugog svetskog rata služio na Pacifiku.
Because of his faith, he did not believe it was right for him to kill anyone.
A zbog svoje vere, verovao je da nema pravo da ubije bilo koga.
And so he chose to be a medic.
I zato je odabrao da bude bolničar.
People mocked him within his part of the army.
Ljudi su u njegovoj jedinici su mu se ismevali.
They said, "You're not doing any good. You're not actually killing the enemy."
I oni su govorili, ti ne činiš ništa dobro zato što ti u stvari ne ubijaš naše neprijatelje.
But during one particular battle that is retold in the movie Hacksaw Ridge.
Ali tokom jedne posebne bitke koja je prikazana u filmu Hacksaw Ridge.
He managed to pull 75 wounded soldiers to safety.
On je uspeo da izvuče 75 ranjenih vojnika u bezbednost.
All he was doing was breathing the Holy Spirit.
A sve što je radio jeste
serving where he could.
Disao je svetog duha i služio gde god je mogao.
There are other examples of table waiters like this.
Postoje drugi primeri ovakvih konobara.
I think of people like Martin Gugino.
Kao Martin Gugino.
He was a 75-year-old computer geek.
On je bio kompjuteraški zaluđenik u svojih 75 godina.
He was at an age when many people would dismiss him as being useless.
I nalazio se u godinama u kojima bi ga mnogi prosto samo gurnuli sa strane kao neupotrebljivog.
But in his spare time he would show up to social causes and protests.
Međutim, u svoje slobodno vreme, on bi se uvek pojavljivao da podrži važne proteste i važne ciljeve.
He was never a good speaker and he never called attention to himself.
Nikada nije bio dobar govornik i nikada nije želeo da privlači pažnju na sebe.
But he believed he needed to show up in order to present himself as a source of help.
Međutim, smatrao je da treba da se pojavi u javnosti kao način pružanja podrške i pomoći.
And so just one day recently in the last couple of weeks,
i samo jednog dana u prethodnih nekoliko sedmica,
he was breathing the breath of God in Buffalo, New York.
On je disao svetog duha u Buffalo, državi New York.
And he began walking across a road toward a group of police officers.
I dok je prelazio put idući u susret grupi policajaca,
who roughly knocked him over and he fell onto the street.
Koji su ga veoma grubo odgurli i zbog čega je on pao na ulici.
Causing some severe head damage.
Tada je zadobio ozbiljnu povredu glave.
And so even though he said nothing,
iako ništa nije rekao,
his example was flashed across TV screens across the country.
O njegovom primeru mogli su da čuju ljudi širom zemlje.
And he became a positive example that people from every age can do important things.
I on je postao pozitivan primer da ljudi svih doba i godina mogu postati primer drugima.
Simply by breathing the breath of God.
Samo tako što će disati Svetog Duha.
There are other examples of this even from places we wouldn't expect.
Postoje mnogi drugi primeri čak na mestima na kojima ih nikad ne bismo očekivali.
I think of people like Albert Einstein.
Poput ljudi kao što je Albert Einstein.
We don't usually think of him as a spiritual giant.
Mi o njemu uglavnom ne mislimo kao o duhovnom divu.
Nevertheless, he was someone who believed in using his talents to serve the world.
Ipak on je verovao da on služi svoje talente kako bi služio svetu.
And I find it very surprising that many of his greatest discoveries did not come when he was a celebrated scientist.
I veoma iznenađujuće da većina njegovih otkrića nisu postala poznata za vreme njegovog života.
When he finished his university education, he couldn't get a job.
Kada je završio svoje univerzitetsko obrazovanje, nije mogao da nađe posao.
Nobody wanted to hire him.
Niko nije želeo da ga zaposli.
So he got employed at a patent office in Bern, Switzerland.
I onda se zaposlio u kancelariji koja se bavila patentima u Bernu, Švajcarskoj.
He was there doing menial tasks.
I tamo je radio neke male, sitne poslove.
He was approving patents for gravel sorters.
On je odobravao patente, I don't know what gravel sorters.
A tool that sorts rocks.
Okay. On je odobravao patente za aparaturu koja seče kamenje.
And in his spare time, he would sit at his desk and work on his equations.
A u slobodno vreme sedeo je za svojim stolom i radio na svojim jednačinama.
And it was during this time working at the lowly patent office.
I za vreme njegovog rada u ovoj maloj kancelariji za patente,
that he discovered the special theory of relativity in 1905.
On je 1905. Godine otkrio teoriju relativiteta.
A discovery that changed the world.
Teoriju, otkriće koje je promenilo svet.
What is the point of these examples?
I šta je poenta ovih primjera?
Your position does not matter.
Vaš položaj nije bitan.
Your reputation does not matter.
Vaša reputacija nije bitna.
What matters is that you breathe the breath of God.
Ono što je bitno jeste da vi udišete taj dah Gospodnji.
That you give yourself to the world in love as God did.
Da dajete sebe svetu s ljubavlju, baš kao što je Gospod činio.
That is what it means to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
I to znači biti ispunjen Duhom Svetim.
Now that we have that positive example in mind,
i sada kada imamo taj pozitivni primjer u našem umu,
I want to look at the way in which we can fail to breathe.
Hteo bih malo da razmatramo jedan način kako možemo da propustimo priliku da dišemo Gospodnjim Duhom.
It's an example we find in Acts chapter 5.
Primer koji nalazimo u Delima u petom poglavlju.
Just to give you a bit of background about what's happening in this passage.
I samo da vam dam malo pozadinskih informacija o onome što se dešava u ovoj glavi.
The wealthier members of the new Christian community,
bogatiji članovi nove hrišćanske zajednice,
have been selling property in order to donate the money to the cause of poverty.
Prodavali su svoje imanje kako bi taj novac donirali za ovu zajednicu.
And so there are two wealthy members of this early community named Ananias and Sapphira.
I tako su postojali između ostalog dva bogata člana ove zajednice, Anani i Safira.
I'll begin reading in verse 1 of chapter 5.
Počet ćemo s prvim stihom.
A man named Ananias, however, with his wife Sapphira, sold a piece of property.
A jedan čovek po imenu Ananije sa ženom svojom Safirom prodade njivu.
He retained for himself, with his wife's knowledge, some of the purchase price, took the remainder, and put it at the feet of the apostles.
I sakrio od novaca sa znanjem i žene svoje, i donesavši jedan del metno apostolima pred noge.
But Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart so that you lied to the Holy Spirit and retained part of the price of the land?
A Petar reče, Ananija, zašto napuni Sotona srce tvoje da slažeš Duha Svetom i sakriješ od novaca što uze za njivu?
While it remained unsold, did it not remain yours? And when it was sold, was it not still under your control? Why did you contrive this deed? You have lied not to human beings, but to God.
Kad je bilo u tebe, ne beše li tvoja? I kad je prodade, ne beše li u tvojoj vlasti? Zašto si dakle takvu stvar metnu u srce svoje? Ljudima nisi slagao, nego Bogu.
When Ananias heard these words, he fell down and breathed his last, and great fear came upon all who heard of it.
A kad ču Ananije reč ovu, pade i izdahnu, i uđe veliki strah u sve koji slušaku ovo.
The young men came and wrapped him up, then carried him out and buried him.
A momci, ušavši, uzeše ga i iznesoše te zakopaše.
After an interval of about 3 hours, his wife came in, unaware of what had happened.
A kad prođe oko 3 sahata, uđe i žena njegova, ne znajući šta je bilo.
Peter said to her, "Tell me, did you sell the land for this amount?" She answered, "Yes, for that amount."
A Petar joj odgovori, "Kaži mi, jesi li za toliko dala njivu?" A ona reče, "Da, za toliko."
Then Peter said to her, "Why did you agree to test the Spirit of the Lord? Listen, the footsteps of those who have buried your husband are at the door, and they will carry you out."
A Petar joj reče, "Zašto se dogovoriste da iskušate duha gospodnjeg? Gle, noge onih koji tvoga muža zakopaše pred vratima su i iznećete."
At once she fell down at his feet and breathed her last. When the young men entered, they found her dead, so they carried her out and buried her beside her husband.
I odmah padne pred nogama njegovim i izdahnu. A momci ušavši nađuše joj mrtvu, iznesoše i zakopaše kod muža njezina.
And great fear came upon the whole church and upon all who heard of these things.
I uđe veliki strah u svu crkvu i u sve koji čuše ovo.
This is a very bizarre story.
Ovo je jedna veoma bizarna priča.
What should we make of it? A few things to note before we apply this passage.
Nekoliko stvari koje bi trebalo da znamo pre nego što...
First, God does not kill Ananias and Sapphira.
Prvo, Bog nije ubio Ananija i Sapfiru.
Conniving ministers could easily use this as a manipulative passage.
Podli sveštenici su veoma lako mogli da koriste ovo za manipulaciju.
They could say, "Unless you give enough money to the church, God will strike you dead."
I mogli su da kažu, "Ako ne date dovoljno para, Bog će vas ubiti."
But as Peter points out, they could do what they wanted with their money.
Ali kao što je Petar rekao, oni su mogli da rade sa svojim novcem šta god su želeli.
Peter says, "When the land was part of your property, couldn't you do with it what you wanted?"
I Petar im lepo kaže, s obzirom da je zemlja bila u vašem vlasništvu, vi ste s njom mogli da radite što god ste želeli.
Their problem was that they were pretending to give everything they had when they weren't.
Problem je bio u tome što su se oni pretvarali da su dali sve što su imali, a u stvari nisu.
Their problem was hypocrisy.
Njihov problem je bio u tome da su bili licemerni.
However, there are many hypocrites that appear in the New Testament.
Međutim, imate dosta licemera koji se pojavljaju u Novom Zavetu.
We see hypocrites popping up all throughout the ministry of Jesus.
Vi možemo pronaći licemere kako se pojavljuju nasumično svuda kroz Hristovu službu.
And it doesn't seem that people just fall over dead every time they become a hypocrite.
I nigde nije zapisano da ljudi prosto padaju mrtvi kada se otkrije da su licemeri.
So what then is the point of this story?
Zato se postavlja pitanje šta je poenta ove priče.
Notice the language that the author uses to describe what happens to Ananias and Sapphira.
Primetite samo jezik koji autor koristi kako bi opisao šta se desilo Anani i Sapfiri.
It says in verse 5, "When Ananias heard these words, he fell down and breathed his last."
U petom stihu kaže, a kad čuo Ananija reč ovu, pade i izdahnu.
And then you turn ahead to verse 10, it says the same thing. "At once she fell down at his feet and breathed her last."
Ista stvar se ponavlja u 10. stihu, i odmah padnu pred nogama njegovim i izdahnu.
The phrase "breathing one's last" is just a colloquial term for dying.
Ovaj izraz izdahnuti je samo jedan sinonim za umiranje.
But at another level there seems to be a reason Luke uses that term.
Međutim, na jednom drugom nivou postoji razlog zašto Luka koristi ovaj termin.
Luke is contrasting what happens to them with what happens to the other disciples.
Luka pravi kontrast između njih i onoga što se desilo Anani i Safiri i šta se desilo drugim apostolima.
By pretending to give everything to the world,
ali sve svoje, a u stvari nisu, njihovo disanje prestaje.
Ananias and Sapphira, because they hold their breath, they pass out and die.
I upravo zbog toga, zato što su zadržali dah, prestali su da dišu, oni su pali mrtvi.
Their hypocrisy deceives even themselves about what they are giving.
Njihovo licemerje čak i njih same prevarilo o onom što oni daju zajednici.
So the best way to stop breathing,
i zato je najbolji način da prestanete da dišete,
is to pretend that you are giving of yourself when you are not.
Jeste da se pretvarate da dajete sebe kada u stvari to ne činite.
By doing so you can lie to the Holy Spirit.
Na taj način vi možete slagati Svetog Duha.
You can lie not only to everyone else, but also to yourself, to your own breath.
I na taj način vi možete lagati ne samo sve druge, već i sebe same.
When we present a false image of ourselves to the world, we begin to suffocate.
Kada predstavimo pogrešnu, lažnu sliku sebe svetu, mi počinjemo da patimo.
The most frightening thing about this is that sometimes we are not even aware that this is what we are doing.
Najstrašnija stvar u svemu tome jeste što mi čak i nismo ni svesni da to radimo.
Unfortunately, lying about ourselves to ourselves is something very common in our modern world today.
Nažalost, u našem današnjem modernom svetu laganje samih sebe je veoma uobičajena stvar.
One of the ways this happens is through the use of social media.
Jedan od načina kako se to dešava jeste svakako upotreba društvenih mreža.
There's this strange impulse that we have to present an image of ourselves to the world.
Postoji taj neki čudan impuls koji mi imamo da sebe predstavimo na određeni način svetu.
In order to have people compliment us about who we are.
A sve u cilju toga kako bi nam ljudi udelili komplimente i pohvale o tome kakvi smo mi.
And this is a normal thing.
I ovo je sasvim normalno.
But it can very quickly become incredibly irrational.
Međutim, veoma brzo to može da postane nešto veoma iracionalno.
For example.
Na primjer.
Imagine that you find a picture of a very attractive person.
Zamislite da ste pronašli sliku veoma privlačne osobe.
You take that picture and you post it online with your name underneath it.
Uzmete tu sliku i onda je postavite na društvenim mrežama kao da ste vi sa svojim imenom ispod.
Suddenly people begin commenting and saying you are so beautiful, you look so amazing.
I onda ljudi počnu da komentarišu vi ste predivni, vi izgledate tako fantastično.
Would doing this make you feel good?
A sve u cilju toga da was that a question or
a question.
Okay. Da li ovo da li biste se zbog ovakog ovakog činjenja osjećali dobro?
All of us rationally would think no.
Svi koji racionalno razmišljamo rekli bismo ne.
The person they are complimenting is not even me.
Zato što osoba koja vam upućuje taj komentar niste vi.
Yet in various ways this is what we all do.
Međutim, na najrazličitije načine to je nešto što mi stalno radimo.
We use filters and we distort images in order to make people think we are something we are not.
Mi koristimo filtere, mi menjamo fotografije kako bismo predstavili ljudima da smo mi nešto što u stvari nismo.
And then people compliment us and like us.
I onda nam ljudi upućuju pozitivne komentare, komplimente i sviđaju im se naše fotografije.
But what they are complimenting and liking is not really us.
Međutim, ono što oni pohvaljuju nismo mi u stvari.
It is a distortion of who we are.
To je u stvari izvrnuta slika onoga što mi u stvari jesmo.
So why then does this make us feel good?
Zašto se onda zbog toga osjećamo dobro?
It's because we have lied to ourselves about what we really are as well.
Zato što smo mi sami sebe lagali o onome šta smo mi.
Now, of course, this can be a fairly silly, trivial thing.
Mislim, ovo može da bude jedna sasvim nespretna, mala stvar, nebitna stvar.
But it becomes much more dangerous when it gets deeper into who we are.
Međutim, postaje mnogo ozbiljnije kada to postane mnogo dublje ukorenjeno u nama, u našem identitetu.
When we persuade ourselves that we are loving and caring when we really are not.
Kada ubedimo sebe kako smo mi brižni, kako volimo druge ljude, u stvari nismo.
Sometimes this happens when we construct justifications for our own selfishness.
To se dešava kada mi stvorimo samoopravdanje za našu ličnu sebičnost.
For example, it is very common for us to believe that we have earned everything we have.
Recimo, veoma je uobičajeno da smatramo da smo mi zaista zaslužili sve što imamo.
We think if we are well off, it is because of our own genius.
Ako smo dobro, to znači da je to zbog naše genijalnosti, naše lične kvaliteta.
Everything I have in my possession is because I have worked for it.
Sve što imam u svom posjedu je zato što sam ja jako radio za to.
Now, of course, sometimes that's true.
Ponekad to je tačno.
And sometimes it's not.
Međutim, ponekad baš i nije.
And the ambiguity there can make us deceive ourselves.
I upravo to je ono što može da nas navede da sami sebe zavaramo.
One of the ways this can happen is through what economists call rent seeking.
Jedan od načina je nešto što ekonomisti nazivaju rent seeking.
Rents. Looking for rent.
Yeah. Traženje stana za iznajmljivanje ili...
The economist Adam Smith,
ekonomista Adam Smith,
distinguished between three different kinds of income.
Pravi razliku između tri različite vrste dobiti.
Profit, wages and rent.
Profit, plata i dobit od iznajmljivanja, od rente.
The first two come about by making things.
Prve dve, profit i zarada, dolaze, izvor toga je vaše činjenje.
For example, an inventor discovers something.
Naprimer, osoba nešto otkrije.
And thereby gets a profit from it.
I dobija profit od tog svog otkrića.
And maybe the people hired to make that invention get wages.
A onda ljudi koji su unajmljeni da realizuju to otkriće dobiju platu za svoj rad.
However, from a technical perspective, rent is something entirely different.
Iz tehničke perspektive, rentiranje, to je zarada od rentiranja, je nešto sasvim drugo.
Rent, in the strict sense, is getting something for nothing.
U najstrožem obliku, definicija rente je da dobijete nešto za ništa.
For example, imagine a king in a castle.
Zamislite kralja u dvorcu.
Who has as part of his property a river.
Koji na svom posjedu, u svom vlasništvu ima reku.
And there are ships that sail along the river.
I brodovi plove tom rekom.
And so at one point the king decides to put chains around that part of the river.
I onda u nekom trenutku kralj odluči da postavi lance na tom delu reke, na njegovom posjedu.
And says to those who are traveling,
i kaže ovima koji prolaze tuda,
if you want to travel by my castle, you must pay me.
Ako želite da prolaze, da plovite pored mog zamka, morate da mi platite.
And then I will raise the chains and allow you to sail through.
I onda ću ja podići, kad vi platite, ja ću podići ove lance i vi ćete moći da proplovite.
This king has not produced anything.
Ovaj kralj ništa nije stvorio.
He has contributed nothing to the economy.
Ni na koji način nije doprineo ekonomiji.
And yet he is getting money.
Ali ipak dobija zaradu.
From a strict perspective, that is rent.
Iz najuže perspektive, to je rentiranje.
And economists point out that rent in that sense is always harmful to the economy.
Ovaj ekonomist je u stvari hteo da istakne kako je dobit od rentiranja loša za ekonomiju.
In that limited sense, rent is always immoral.
U tom malom ograničenom smislu, dobit od rente je u stvari nemoralna.
However, in practice, things are not so simple.
Međutim, u praksi stvari nisu tako jednostavne.
Most of the people whom we pay rent to today don't do that.
Većina ljudi kojima mi plaćamo rentu ne čine to.
For example, if you own an apartment,
na primjer, ako imate u vlasništvu stan,
you might rent it out to someone,
iznajmili ste ga nekome,
but that's because you are taking care of the apartment while they live there.
Ali to je zato što se vi brinete o stanu dok neko drugi živi o njemu.
You make sure the building doesn't fall apart.
Vi se brinete o tome da se zgrada ne raspadne.
And they pay you money in exchange.
I oni vam plaćaju za uzvrat.
The problem is that these two different understandings of rent bleed together.
Problem je u tome što se ova dva različita razumevanja rente u nekom trenutku spajaju.
It is very difficult to tell if someone is rent seeking in the negative way.
Jako je teško reći da li je to rentiranje, to je dobrobit od rente, negativna.
Or whether they are actually contributing something by receiving rent.
Ili da li vlasnik koji prima novac od rente u stvari doprinosi.
And so this enables us to easily deceive ourselves.
I na ovaj način mi možemo se nađemo u poziciji da se veoma lako obmanemo.
It is possible to go through life contributing nothing.
Moguće je ići kroz život, a da ne doprinosite ni na koji način.
And yet acquiring a great amount of wealth.
A opet da stičete veliko bogatstvo.
And the only way we can know is by careful self-examination.
A jedini način kako možemo biti sigurni u to gde se nalazimo jeste da se veoma detaljno bavimo analizom samih sebe.
And because of the complexity of the economy, this is hard.
A zbog kompleksnosti ekonomije ovo je veoma teško.
And as it turns out, the more wealth you have, the harder it gets to do.
Ispostavilo se da što ste bogatiji, to je teže činiti ovo.
This is why Jesus refers to the deceitfulness of wealth in one of his parables.
I zato Hristos govori o prevarljivosti bogatstva u jednoj od svojih priča.
Just the other day I discovered $20 on the street.
Pre neki dan sam pronašao $20 na ulici.
I picked it up as I was running.
I pokupio sam ih dok sam trčao.
At first I felt bad because somebody lost $20.
Na trenutak sam se osjećao loše zato što je neko izgubio $20.
But I noticed as I was running down the street,
ali sam primetio dok sam trčao niz ulicu,
I began persuading myself unconsciously.
Nesvesno sam počeo sebe da ubeđujem.
Trying to tell myself that it was my own ingenuity that had enabled me to find this $20.
Pokušavao sam da objasnim da je samo sebi da je moja genijalnost, moja sposobnost zaslužena za to da ja pronađem tih $20.
I started to think I deserve this because my eyes are so much better than everyone else's.
Počeo sam da razmišljam, ja u stvari zaslužujem ovih dolara zato što su moje oči bolje od tuđih očiju.
Nobody else would have seen this $20 bill.
Niko drugi ne bi video ovu novčanicu.
But I did and therefore I deserve it.
Ali ja jesam i zato je zaslužujem.
Now, of course, there was no way to restore that $20 to the original owner.
Naravno, nije postao način da se tih $20 vrati vlasniku.
And so in that case, it was probably okay for me to hold on to it.
I u tom smislu bilo je sasvim u redu da ja zadržim taj novac.
But it's that mechanism of self-soothing.
Međutim, taj mehanizam samouljuljkivanja
that enables us to deceive ourselves about how loving towards others we really are.
Koji nam omogućuje da mi sebe ubedimo to koliko mi u stvari drugima volimo druge.
And the more we deceive ourselves, the more we stop breathing.
I što više mi same sebe obmanjujemo, mi sve više prestajemo da dišemo.
To be completely breathless in terms of the Holy Spirit.
Da postanemo apsolutno bez vazduha u kontekstu Svetog Duha
is to begin to look at life as a process of getting things.
Jeste da počnemo na život da gledamo kao na proces sticanja stvari.
When all you want to do in life is get more stuff from other people,
kada je jedino što želite da činite da uzmete stvari od drugih ljudi,
what you are really doing is holding your breath.
Ono što vi u stvari radite jeste da vi zadržavate svoj dah.
It can be very exciting.
To može da bude veoma uzbudljivo.
It can be thrilling to get more and more things.
Može da vas uzbuđuje da idete ka tome da stičete sve više i više.
But at the end of your life you can discover that you have not really lived at all.
Međutim, na kraju svog života možete da otkrijete da vi u stvari uopšte niste živeli.
And so my invitation to you today is to ask whether you are breathing.
I zato vas ja pozivam da danas zapitate sami sebe da li dišete.
Whether you are living by giving to others.
Da li zaista živite dajući drugima?
And to do this, I invite you to think of Jesus as a standard.
A da biste to učinili, ja vas pozivam da uzmete Hrista kao svoj standard.
Many of us think in order to live a great life, we must travel.
Mnogi od nas misle da biste zaista proživjeli život, vi morate da putujete.
Jesus lived his entire life in a region no larger than Wisconsin.
A Hristos je ceo svoj život proživeo u regionu koji nije veći od Wisconsina.
Many of us think that in order to live a great life we need to own our own house.
Mnogi od nas misle da bismo živeli dobar život, mi treba da posjedemo veliku kuću.
Jesus, it says, had no place to lay his head.
Za Hrista se kaže da nije imao mesta na kom bi položio glavu.
Many of us think in order to live a great life we need to write a book.
Neki smatraju da je živeti dobar život napisati knjigu.
As far as we know, Jesus never wrote anything.
Koliko mi znamo, Hristos nikada ništa nije napisao.
Many of us assume that in order to live a great life, we need to be married.
Mnogi od nas smatraju da treba da budemo venčani.
Jesus, as it turns out, was not.
A ispostavilo se da Hristos nije.
And of course, many of us think in order to live a great life, we need to live long, well into old age.
Naravno, mnogi od nas smatraju da je živeti dobar život znači živeti dug život do starosti.
With robust health and perfect skin.
Sa savršenim zdravljem i kožom.
Jesus died when he was in his mid-30s.
Hristos je umro u svojim ranim 30-tim.
Of course, there is nothing wrong with traveling, writing books, being married, living long.
Naravno, nema ništa loše u tome da putujete, da pišete knjige, da se ženite ili udajete, da živite dugo.
All of these things can be part of breathing the Holy Spirit.
Sve ove stvari mogu da budu delovi koji vam govore da vi dišete dah Gospodin.
The problem is when we begin to use them as metrics.
Međutim, problem je u tome kad počinjemo da ih koristimo kao parametre.
To measure our success in life.
Da merimo naš uspeh u životu.
The philosopher Abraham Joshua Heschel.
Filozof Abraham, I forgot the name.
Joshua Heschel.
Joshua Heschel.
Pointed out that human beings' deepest desire is to be needed.
Istakao je da je najdublja čežnja želja da vas drugi žele, da drugi potrebuju za vama.
At a basic level, we all want to give to the world.
I na nekom osnovnom nivou mi zaista želimo da damo sve svetu.
The mistake we make is in substituting that desire for the desire to have our needs met.
Međutim, greška koju činimo jeste kada tu želju da damo svetu zamenimo željom da svet izađe u susret našim potrebama.
This is fundamentally what idolatry is.
I ovo je ono što je suštinski prevara.
Idolatry is not worshiping objects necessarily.
To ne znači da vi nužno obožavate objekte.
It is framing God as getting things.
Već Boga stavljate u kontekst dobijanja stvari.
Thinking about the deity as a way to acquire more stuff.
Kada posmatrate božanstvo kao vaše sredstvo da vi dobijete više.
Rather than realizing that God is agape love.
Nego više da Boga posmatrate kao Boga ljubavi.
We experience God truly in the act of self-giving.
I mi Boga istinski doživljavamo u svakom činu davanja.
So how do we know then whether we are idolaters or not?
I kako onda da znamo da li smo prevarljivi ili ne?
I think there's a simple test we can use.
Postoji jedan veoma jednostavan test.
It's one that I try to use myself, although I must admit not very successfully most of the time.
To je test koji ja pokušavam da koristim da testiram na sebi, međutim moram priznati da nisam baš naročito uspešan.
The test is this.
A test je sledeći.
Think about what you think about as soon as you wake up in the morning.
Pomislite šta je vaša prva misao kad se probudite.
For me, most of the time, this is hard.
Za mene, moja prva misao jeste ovo je teško.
When I woke up this morning, the first thing I thought was, it is very hot in this room.
Prvo pomisao ovog jutra bila je veoma toplo u ovoj sobi.
But I've discovered that sometimes my thought process can go in one of two ways in the morning.
Međutim, otkrio sam da povremeno tok mojih misli može da ode u jednom od dva pravca.
I can motivate myself to give up or to get up by two different ways.
Mogu sebe da motivišem da ustanem iz kreveta na dva različita načina.
One of the ways is to think about things that I want.
Jedan od načina je da mislim o stvarima koje želim.
Things that I want to get in that particular day.
Stvarima koje želim da dobijem u tom konkretnom danu.
And although that happens a lot,
iako se to dešava često,
that is the foundation of idolatry.
To je osnova prevare, tako reći.
Because if I go through that entire day only thinking about things that I'm going to get,
Jer ako ja idem kroz dan sam vođen mišlju šta ja mogu da dobijem,
I will not experience the reality of who God is.
Ja nikada neću iskusiti realnost onoga što Bog zaista jeste.
And so my goal, my aspiration,
i zato je moj cilj, moje stremljenje,
is to wake up and think about how I can give to the world in that particular day.
Jeste da se probudim i da mislim o tome kako ja mogu da doprinesem svetu tog konkretnog dana.
How I can experience the agape love of God.
Kako mogu da iskusim tu agape ljubav Gospodnju.
how I can breathe.
Kako da dišem.
And although I fail at that task quite frequently,
iako nisam baš uspešan u tom zadatku, i to veoma često,
I invite you and myself to join in that task.
Ja vas pozivam kao i sebe da se pridružite tom svakodnevnom zadatku.
The experience of breathing the breath of God every day.
Da iskusite kako je disati Duhom Gospodnjim svakoga dana.
This is my prayer for all of us.
I ovo je moja molitva za sve nas.
Amen.
Amen.